don't jerk me. Lima green and mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl, she tryna jerk me. Lima green and mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl, she
Universe, though we ain't ready.
This is the debut. This is the kickoff of Young Guns comedy right here. Are y'all ready for this? Is the question.
Hopefully they are. Hey everybody, welcome to the Young Guns of Comedy. I'm your host Shay Dixon, aka the Media Queen, aka the illest chick alive. And
okay, I agree with you. Good work.
I know. I was gonna add more, but I figured. I have a, yes.
Give us two AKA more titles to yourself.
Miss Goody Two Shoes, okay. AKA Miss Perfect.
Oh, are we taking it
Miss
there?
Miss Perfect?
Okay, yes. Hey, you know, you
can
modest.
Can I do that?
You okay. Modest like
yeah,
that.
I try to be humble.
Okay, I see what you're doing. Right. I see what you're doing. Okay. I'm Tony Baker, you know, AKA Tony Baker, you know. I'm on Twitter, at Tony Baker Comedy. I do jokes for a living. I do jokes for cash. That's what I do. I'm a comedian.
Wrong with that.
Yeah.
Really?
You know, yeah. Yeah.
Well, right now we're missing somebody in our team that will be here shortly.
Be here shortly.
We love him. He's on a plane, you know, and he's on his way here immediately.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. But who are you, madam?
Yes. Yeah, I'm going into me, but first I wanted to represent BT Kingsley before he got here.
Okay, then.
My name is Killer KB, slaying stages left and right.
Okay, then.
Okay, whoop, whoop. On my way to be the next queen of comedy in this month.
Okay, then.
Heard that. Okay.
What the KB stand for, though?
Killer KB, pal. That's my cough. I've been to jail a couple times. They well do that, played. So now it's stuck in me. there's a lot of stuff going on today. But before we do that, we want to get into somebody very special that's sitting to the right of us. You better go on and talk, Mama, with your good old products.
Hello, my name is Kellyanne with Kellyanne Products.
Okay, then.
This is my Tomboy Gel.
And it is
used
awesome.
By Sugar Shay Mosley. Okay. Let's check it out.
Cool. I've used it. I actually use this all
did
the
you
time.
Use it?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
I use it on my hair.
Right
here.
Right.
Like,
yeah, right?
Really, I'm African American. My hair normally does not wave up and lay down like
he
this.
He got yours. He got his.
Smells good.
He always got
his. Do this work for mixed people?
Yeah.
It does. Right. Actually, Sugar Shay Mosley uses it. He has curly hair. People with straight hair uses it just to actually lay the hair down.
Okay.
And we also use it, most women use it when they have their ponytails. You want to slick it down, you want to work out, you want your hair to look sexy, shines with no flakes.
Yeah, this smells good. Yeah. It smells delicious.
It smells like Terrell Moody. I used to have sex with him back in the day.
Well, that's some good stuff then, girl.
Does that?
Cool water. That's what it is. Cool water.
That's exactly
97.
And Sugar Shay wear that during his fights,
though.
You
know your men.
Does he wear that during his fights?
No.
Oh, no, he
put it on after.
Oh, after?
He puts it on after.
Nobody's gloves smell like that product?
He smelled good way before. Okay. And he puts it on way after.
Okay, I see what's happening. I see what's happening.
Listen, I know cool water. Listen, in the 11th grade had cool water. I was hot.
I want y'all to call in. Call in 323-965-1600. I want y'all to call in because we got some serious topics. Well, not even serious. They could be serious. It just depends on y'all take on it.
It's
what
are
we talking
serious.
About today?
Sex on the first date.
Okay.
And no. Negative.
What?
You already shooting it?
Already, but...
Even with the product?
Yeah, look, if you meet a baby face looking and they
with
got that slip right here,
you're not going to you gonna have sex on the first date. Yeah.
Come
if
on.
You use this product, I'm sorry.
Get into the happy hour, TGI Fridays, Magic Johnson, Ladera Center.
Right.
With that in his hair, you're not
all right, well, hey, guys.
All right, listen, you guys, we're going to go to break real quick. Don't forget to check out KellyAnnProducts.com to get your hair right, and maybe you get some on the first date. Not from Shade, but shit, maybe from me. Listen, I love niggas with good hair. We're going to go to a break right quick. Again, don't forget to call in, and this is Young Guns of Comedy, and we'll be right back.
All right, then.
Oh, Gucci bandana. Gucci bandana. Gucci Gucci bandana. Gucci bandana. Gucci Gucci bandana. Gucci bandana. Gucci Gucci bandana.
Nigga wanna bet ice on my neck, got ice in my ears. Hit the club, niggas looking at me.
Welcome back to the Young Guns of Comedy. I'm Shay Dixon.
I'm Tony Baker.
I am Killer KB, Kenesha Buss. We have our special guest right now,
Miss Kelly Ann.
Miss Kelly Ann, I am.
With the beautiful hair product.
Thank you. Yes, I do have beautiful hair products.
That will get you sex on the first date.
See what you do.
It just
do you guarantee that?
I don't, but I think with some of the alcohol the she has back there.
What's the percentage?
The percentage?
Yeah. If I put that on my bald head, what's the percentage of me getting some on the first date?
I thought he was going to say balls. I was like,
a whole lot, because your hair would be shiny and sleek. You might just slide into some.
Okay, then. I like
see?
That.
You know, see? Now, don't ask me nothing else. I'm going to tell you the truth.
Okay.
All right.
Speaking of sliding into some, let me tell you something. I am the resident alcoholic on the show. Give it up for the alcoholics in the building.
Yeah. Alcoholism.
So every Tuesday, I'm going to be bringing you a drink original. Over my lifetime, I have created over 217 drinks, 18 depending on the shit that spilled on the floor. So today, the drink I'm bringing you, it is called the Sparkling Teardrop. The reason why, every dude I know with a teardrop drinks Parmesan. That's real hood stuff. So what you got to do is you got to take the Parmesan, okay? That's 1/3 Parmesan. I didn't do good at math. Mix the apple juice with it. And then you go mix. This is what killed you, because every nigga you know drink Parmesan with the apple juice. But what makes it the sparkling teardrop is you got to add the white grape sparkling water, and they put it on. It make you feel a little bit classy, like you still roll with the hood niggas, but you graduated. You don't got a GED type thing. You know what I'm saying? It's one of those. And I'm gonna take a sip for y'all right now, let you know how it feels. And everybody out there knows Parmesan ain't no. Actually, cause Shay, you know she be trying to act all good.
I stopped drinking.
When?
Last week.
Okay, but let me tell you, you got a week under your belt, so you should celebrate.
Hey, while she's celebrating, call in, y'all. 323-965-1600.
Quick one.
Call in right now.
Set that on the table for me, Tony. It's taking up my personal space.
Taking it, all right,
how does that taste?
That's what's up.
It's actually delicious.
So
if I drink today, maybe I can stop drinking again at the end of the show.
Yeah, at the end of the show. And then every week we'll celebrate. Every Tuesday, your 1 week progress. How you feel about that?
I'm not with it.
She's going to be with it.
Sparkling
teardrop, everybody. Make sure you get it. It's going to be a hit at the parties, I promise you.
But it's good. It doesn't taste like alcohol at all. Mm-mm.
Oh, look at her taking a swig. There we go. Dang, she's taking it to the dome piece.
Okay,
though.
Back to our topic.
KB is
sex
about to be
on the first date.
Yeah,
so how many of these do you have when you're on your first date?
None or 10. It don't matter.
Okay, so sex on the first date. Let's see, yay or nay from everybody on the panel.
I'm not opposed to it, you know.
So that's a yay?
If you're feeling the vibe, okay. First of all, call in with your take on this. 323-965-1600. Let us know yay or nay from you. For me, personally, I'm a hypochondriac, so I probably won't have sex on the first date. But if I wasn't, sex on the first date is all good, even in the movie theater.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just me, guys? Just me?
Tanisha?
Let me tell you something about sex on the first date. Not only do I agree with it, why am I waiting? People wait till you get married. If it's bad, I want to know up front, because it ain't going to be a date number two. So I need to know what is my jack in the box immediately.
If you go on 7 dates and y'all finally smash, and the smash is whack-tacular?
Then I'm mad I didn't hit on the first date.
No. Because if you wait, then you can actually grow feelings for somebody. And then
nobody
when you
care about
it,
feelings.
It can be good.
No feelings. What are we talking about? Sex.
Well, 2012. Ain't nobody special no more.
I have some statistics, guys. I actually done some homework.
Need those stats.
57% of Americans have had sex outdoors or in a public place.
Ooh.
What's up? That's what's up.
I'm one of those.
I'm part of that percentage.
What about you, Kellyanne?
I'm part of that percent right there.
Really? So, I mean, just outside, like on benches, playgrounds.
On the porch at a college dormitory. That was
I had sex at the beach with a bunch of kids in the water.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Wait, you had sex with kids?
Sometimes. Well, 17. Let's talk to Good Hair. Let's see what she do on the, you know, she inventing products and all. What is she doing on the first
She
date?
Was outside. I don't know.
I was outside.
See what you're doing.
All right. You know what
Did
I'm
you
doing.
Have product
if the hair is beautiful and fabulous, you might as well slip a condom on that other head and have a good time.
Okay,
I'm not mad. I am not mad. Hey. Just protect yourself. If you feel like doing it, I don't think it's always okay, but if it's something you want to do, body horny, getting older, want to have a little bit of fun, have some.
Now, not only did you protect yourself sexually outside, but did you protect yourself from the sun outside?
Actually, yes, I did, because I was under a shaded tree.
Okay,
ask somebody.
With grease, guys. We're cooking.
So, out of our panel, three out of four said yes to sex on the first date.
Yes,
I wouldn't tell my
Statistics
daughter that.
Statistics say that 29% have had sex on the first date. So, almost 30% of people have had sex on the first date.
Yeah.
Our statistics aren't the same. This is 75%.
I've never had sex on the
first date. Oh, you haven't? Okay, so 50%.
But I would, though.
If you weren't a hypochondriac.
Right.
What is that? Because some people don't know what that word is.
I think I have every disease known to man at all times.
Oh.
Yeah, I can leave the doctor. Everything's negative.
Do you got a permanent right now?
Call the doctor back.
What makes you feel like that you have one of the permanents? Does it burn when you go pee, Tony?
It doesn't even matter, dog. Even when Magic revealed his status, I was a virgin at the time, but I knew I had what he had just because he had it, and I knew who he was. I was like, I got it too, Magic. I feel you. So what? I was 11.
I'm over Tony. Is anybody... Oh, snap!
BT
Kingsley's in the building!
Hey, call in. Let us know what you think about sex on the first date. 323-965-1600. Don't be shy to call in. We want to know what you think more than we think. Call us.
So make sure you're getting your phones ready. We're going to take a quick break right now. And don't forget to support our sponsor, KellyAnnProducts.com.
Yes.
Go get them waves right so you can hit that tight.
Yeah.
Oh, that was nice. That was nice. Beautiful hair is what's up. Sexy hair is always in style. Okay, so beautiful, so soft, oh, so Kellyanne. Try my leave-in conditioner for all hair types, especially extensions. Or my tomboy gel used by the one and only Sugar Shay Mosley. To learn more about Kellyanne products, go to www.kellyanneproducts.com. That's www.kellyanneproducts.com. Or join my Facebook page at Kelly Ann Hair. And remember, be beautiful today with Kelly Ann Products.
Dance, 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 dance. Swallow as them bitches touch my wood. Jump time at the Apollo.
Go. I'm that body.
What is up, everybody? We are back. Welcome to the Young Guns of Comedy, where not laughing is actually against the law. I am Shay Dixon.
I'm Tony Baker, guys. Okay.
You know, it's Killer KB, Kenesha Bus, and we got to bring in our fourth member of the team. Mr. B.T. Kingsley, go ahead and introduce yourself and explain why you was late, homie.
It's your boy B.T. Kingsley, a.k.a. Kingsley. You know what it is. I just got off a flight coming from Phoenix for NBC for a little showcase and all that good stuff.
Did you smash in Phoenix?
I did smash. Yeah. Wait.
were you on a stage? First date that you had sex you were in Phoenix? Did you go on a first date and then have sex?
No, I had sex and then went on a date.
Damn,
I need to know what I'm getting into.
Okay. So clearly your response to sex on the first date, yes or no, is yes.
Sex on the first date. I like women that can make a strong decision and are confident in whatever they choose. If you choose and you ready to get down and it makes sense and the energy's right and the mood is right, then hey, by all means, let's partake.
Okay. Music involved or no?
Yeah, I like the music involved.
Okay, that's
old school shit.
Old school?
Yeah, Genuine, 100% out.
That's old school.
But wait, how do you listen to music and have sex outside?
You do it to the rhythm, like if he was dancing. Have you ever had sex outside? How do you play music? I got a convertible so I can have sex outside and inside at the same time.
Okay. At the same damn time. Okay, then.
And then Tony Baker.
Don't forget y'all call in.
Don't forget to call in, y'all. 323-965-1600. We want to know what y'all think about sex on the first day. Call in. Y'all being shy with them fingers.
Call in. And I guarantee you, if you make them a sparkling teardrop with the parmesan, apple juice, and the grape sparkling water, she going to give it up on the first date.
That's the hair product.
They probably don't have to tell her that it's alcohol because it doesn't taste like it.
Shay drank some of my drink. I disguise every drink not to taste like alcohol. I'm the resident alcoholic, but I don't like to taste alcohol. Yeah. Weird, but I like to be turned.
Shay's a sipper. She's a sneaky sipper. She don't like drink. She likes to taste.
Let me taste that. She tastes it.
She probably do that on the dick too. Let me taste it. Not on the first date.
I don't even do that.
You don't even do that.
I don't. I've never.
You've never given head in your entire life.
No, I'm waiting for my husband.
Are you serious?
Yeah. The white woman inside me wants to choke the hell out of you.
So you're waiting to disappoint your husband with
I've watched YouTube videos. No. I've read books.
Tell us the story about it. We want to know the story.
Me and my friends, we used to practice. Not on each other or anything like that because they're girls. Mm. But on like different things.
Fruit product?
Yeah. So I know how.
Like a hairbrush?
I'm waiting until
Does your homegirl stand behind you and push your hand? You got to be ready for elements.
Bananas don't have veins.
I never thought about different distractions.
Don't have veins.
You know how to dodge it when it come out too quick. You don't know none of the skills. It shouldn't be doing that.
You don't know what the
question is. Fruit was not spontaneous.
You got to decide if you're going to dip that first.
My inner white woman is out. She's here.
You got to decide if you're going to give hair first. And then after you decide that, then you got to decide if you a swallower or a spitter.
Well, I haven't gotten to that yet. So I'll just.
I got a lot of work to do.
I can't believe this.
I've never heard. This is crazy.
It's the ultimate in
Texas. Well, I'm from the South. You know, we're.
I don't know.
Texas. I've got a lot of mouth in the South.
Family, like, I don't think my
the
dad
pastor gets head. Listen.
I got hella mouth in the South. Y'all make sure y'all call in.
I want y'all to call in 323-965-1600. We want to know what y'all think about sex on the first date. That's enough of us. We want to know what y'all think about it. Tell us your story, if you will.
Let us know what's going on.
Lack of a better word, homie.
But while we waiting for you to call, I need to understand. You ain't never gave head?
No.
Have you ever handled a penis?
What do you mean handle? Like touched it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I have hand sanitizer next to
me. Yeah, surgical gloves.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is why mixed women exist, because black women ain't giving out hair, so they went to the white
mama. That might be true.
That's why mixed kids is populating.
Hey, my mom is mixed, so I don't want to go there.
Because she got your pawpaw by giving up that good head, Tony Baker.
You just said Tony Baker mama give head.
She really did.
So, sex on the first date,
How many times have you had sex on the first date, BT?
I'm not really that guy. I'll be honest with you. There's been times where, what do you call the first date? Because I've spent like a whole day with a woman and then we'll have sex.
Is that a first date?
You know what?
People don't go on dates anymore. Yeah.
It's like 2 days. I work on a time constraint. Anytime I've had sex with a woman, let me not say anytime, that'd be exaggeration. But most of the time, 85%, I got to know her pretty well. Now, I might have just, we got to call her.
Oh, wait a minute.
I hope it was the girl I had sex with.
Billy from Texas is going to come in and tell us about sex on the first date. Come on, Billy. Talk to us, Daddy.
Hey, I'm like this, dog. Hey, why that girl don't suck no dick? What's up with that?
Why are you so graphic? I'm just waiting for the right penis to suck. It hasn't came yet.
Hey, well, I be wanting to know right then, though. Why you don't want to suck dick that right then? Why I gotta wait?
Well, I feel so offended when you're talking to me this way. I don't know. Really aggressive in Texas.
I like Billy. Girl, that is bigger in Texas.
Kenesha does. Oh, do you, oh, you're not worried about me.
You suck dick?
I'm half white. I was born sucking. I came out sucking. Just
hilarious. Hilarious.
My mama can't afford all this. Listen, what can we work out?
I wish your Twitter so I can get at you there.
It is Kanisha is comedy. K-A-N-I-S-H-A is comedy.
I'm going to see if you really do suck on that dick, y'all. Hey, I like the show, though.
It has to be a suck-worthy dick. It has to at least be six.
When I tell you she's going to play you to the left so quick.
And don't forget to follow Young Guns of Comedy on Twitter as well.
All right. Good looking out. I like the show.
All right, appreciate it, Bill.
All right, now we got another caller coming in. Her name is Candace. Again, she is from El Texas, is on us. And again, Candace, come on in with Sex on the First Date, boo.
There's nothing wrong with having sex on the first date as long as it ain't in the butt.
Whoa. You wait till the second, third day to put it in the butt. How long do you wait before you let somebody put in the butt?
Oh, wow. At least the second date.
Oh! Candace gets it in Texas.
So is that common for you, Candace? Do a lot of men that you meet want to put it in your butt?
They do.
Yeah.
Really? Wow. Are they gay? Are you in Atlanta by any chance?
Yeah, Texas.
Oh, no. Do you? No.
And you know,
are
Texas
they from Atlanta?
I've been to Atlanta.
Oh.
Have you been on first
date? Let me tell you something, Candace. If a dude is only trying to put it in your butt, it's something wrong with him.
Yeah. If he goes straight to the butt and neglects the vagina, you need to second guess this brother.
Butt is clearly the third best hole on a woman's body. I think we all know that.
Everybody has a hole like that. Only women have that sweet, sweet vagina.
And
but you know what? Butt is like, that's a relationship type shit. Like that second, you're like, baby,
that's
listen.
That's nasty.
Let's get a wall. Let me see what else you got.
I'm not in the anal, man.
Candace, do you have any kids?
No.
Have you ever had sex in public, Candace? Not in the butt, just in general.
Yeah.
Wait, okay. Tell us a story. Where you had sex at?
In front of a grocery store.
Walmart?
In front of
Walmart, they got good sales. So
that's
hilarious. Walmart,
and it's 24 hours.
Was you working? She was pushing baskets.
Did you find a sale?
Butt.
Did the guy buy the stuff that you got on sale in Walmart, and then y'all went outside and you had sex with him?
Was it a rollback?
Okay,
was it the old dude at the door?
Listen, Candace, they want to know a lot from you. We appreciate you calling in. Please tune in every Tuesday to Young Guns of Comedy, 7 p.m. Tell all your friends, your friends' friends, and your friends' friends' friends that we're gonna be getting it cracking. We're gonna keep talking about sex and public now. Thank you again, Candace, for calling in. We love you, boo.
And follow us
thank
on Twitter.
You.
Follow Young us Guns on Comedy. Twitter, Young Guns of Comedy. All right, real quick, y'all, what we're going to do is we're going to go to break real quick. And before we do that, we want to give another shout out to our sponsor, KellyAnnProducts.com.
Oh, yeah.
Put it in your hair, and then you might get them underwears.
On the first day.
On the first
perhaps
day.
Kellyanne Products.
Just made up a
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Young Guns of Comedy. We will be here every Tuesday, 7 p.m. Pacific Time, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, and 9 p.m. Central Standard Time. So make sure you guys join us every time we are here. I am Shay Dixon.
I'm Tony Baker.
This your boy BT Kingsley, aka Kingsley.
Hey, this is Killer KB, aka Kenesha Buss. Right now, y'all, we had a little bit of a mix-up. The number has actually changed. I know we put out a lot of posts. The number actually is 323-965-1600. 1600. I'm about to put it on Twitter and Facebook. I know y'all been waiting to call in, a couple people I talked to. So come on, let us know. And also, don't forget to sip on your sparkling teardrop with that Parmesan apple juice and that sparkling cider. And a side note, so these guys want to, we was talking about sex in the city and and what's going on these first dates. And for me, let me tell you something, sex on a first date is thebomb.com. and I actually used to, I know this is bad and I hope my granny ain't listening, when I was 11 I used to watch my mom give head in the bathroom to my stepdad through the peephole. I did. And so it's funny when she said I don't give head, and I was like, no wonder niggas love white women, like my mother's white. And I used to look at her like, go bitch go. I see what's going on.
You really thought that at 11? Go bitch go.
Cause she was skilled. I was sitting there like, fuck Harriet Tubman, I wanna be like her one day.
That's not good.
Hysterical. It's not hysterical, it's true. And if you ask anybody I've been with, they're like, oh, she learned her skills real well.
So on that, on the note of that jiggle right there, I just got a text that asked me, Kenesha, can you tell them, can you stand up so people can see what you got on? Because people was watching and you're looking real supple right now.
Say what?
Supple.
They don't supple. They don't want to see nothing from here up. That's all they want to see is titties plus titties.
Can they see it?
Yes, they are. They're real. They're I'm not gonna tell you the size. If you got a caller, you can come in and guess.
None of your business.
And if you get it right, you can go on a first date.
38 triple D's.
And can you see where's the?
Yeah.
Also, if you're listening and it sounds blurry, go ahead and turn your volume down. You'll be able to hear us. That's what they
want to
see. Is it this?
Yeah.
Yeah, those are all me.
Young Guns of Comedy.
Young Guns of Comedy.
Follow us on Twitter.
Why you in the background with the porn voice, BT?
Like, we have like a caller.
All right, right now we're going to talk to Antoine from Florida. Let me let you know what you know about sex on the first date, baby, baby.
What up, Tony Baker, Kenesha,
what's good? Hey.
This is Antoine Robinson, the comedian.
Hey, with yourself. What's going on? What you do? You have sex on the first date? Yes or no?
Yeah, of course.
Why?
Because I'm married, so I can do that.
Oh, wait. So you have sex with your wife on every first date? Or with different women you're not with your wife on, but you're on different.
On you and
dates.
Your wife's first date, did y'all have sex?
Let me tell you a story. This is really crazy. We were on a date. When I took her on the way before we got married, I took her to the beach. I'm trying to be sexy and everything, do my little Tyrese thing. And she brought her son, and her son was like 3 or 4 months. And we're in the back of my car, like kissing, right? So while we're kissing, the baby started crying. Wow. And my wife actually started breastfeeding her kid while she was kissing me. Like, why did I keep doing it though? I don't know.
That's
like,
why you married her. The bitch is a freak. What?
Maybe I need help.
She took the newborn seed to the first date. That's gangster.
No.
She pulled her titties out on the first date.
She
had a baby. She had to feed the baby. But so it wasn't right for you to continue to kiss her.
I was kissing my wife and looking at the baby. The baby looking at me. I'm looking at him.
So in essence, that was a threesome.
If she was gonna let me hit it that night, you know what? I wasn't gonna turn it down, but I wouldn't have felt right after.
Yeah. That ain't right. If y'all got a story like Antoine's or something equivalent, let me let you know. Call in to 323-965-1600. I made a mistake. But before we even go there, I got a question for the panel. I know Shay probably gonna say no, because that's mini goody two shoot. Miss Perfect. Mix, I got everything on lock, and I'm probably gonna have a husband, bitch, while you don't. It's okay. You don't gotta judge me. Who in here has had a threesome? Starting with Tony Baker.
I have. I've turned down a couple. Oh. I've never committed to the threesome.
Must have been the dimples.
I don't know, you know. Hey.
Dimple-like. Why didn't you commit, though? What made you say,
First off, I was a virgin still, so I was terrified. And luckily, I passed on it because one of the girls had chlamydia. I found out later.
Wow.
I'm like, woo, bullet dodge. Bullet dodge. And ever
What's
since,
her name?
I ain't gonna use that confidentiality. I don't even remember her name, honestly, though. But she I dodged that young bullet. But I've turned him down, though.
Good job. Congratulations on that.
I'm sure you agree with that, Shay, you tight ass. Have you ever had a onesome?
I have, but I'm waiting for my husband to have threesomes.
You know what? Well, you and his husband is getting on my nerves. Right?
And his fictitious husband.
I bet your husband has some threesomes.
Fictitious.
Oh. He don't exist yet. He's just random made up.
It doesn't matter. He will. I speak it into existence and then it happens. Oh.
Call in, guys. I want you guys to call in. Let us know.
Give head tonight.
Let us know if y'all had a threesome. Call
she's
in.
A special guy.
At 323-965-1600. Call in and tell us your stories. Have you had a threesome?
And BC let Kingsley, have you?
I've never had a threesome. You know what? The threesome blew up in my face because more than once because one of the girls decided to like me right in the middle of it. Also, like,
shit.
I want to be with you shit. I'm like, no. I'm trying to make it go down. I left them both there. I was aggravated. I was like,
you left them where?
I left them at their house. I said, if I'm not fucking both of y'all, I'm not fucking nobody.
They were
roommates? How about that? Yes.
This bitch got to put up an extra 20 in
Sacramento. I left them both there. That happened twice. One of them, two titties in my hand and everything's going down and then one of them gets up and is like,
That me and the girl look at each other. They never wanted to do it in the first place.
That sounds good to me and the girl looking at each other. She was like, what's wrong with her? I was like, I don't know. That's your damn friend. She go outside, talk to her, came back and was like, I don't know. She said she likes you. I was like, good. Tell her get her ass back in here. She like, no, she likes you. I was like, man, fuck that shit. I'm finna go. Mm. Now we ain't got some other pussy.
Sounds disappointing.
Kingsley. It was very disappointing.
Yeah.
Well,
who's giving threesomes out there? Call in.
What about Kenesha?
On the first date. Kenesha.
Call in on the first date. Threesome.
Call in on the first date.
I've never had a threesome on the first date.
Okay.
Well, you've had a threesome.
Okay, well listen, let me tell you what happened. If you want to count, there was three people there.
Okay.
I don't know. My grandmother is listening. Damn. But you know what? I got it from her. First of all, I'm gonna shout my granny out because she that's the same caller. Cause she was the only woman to ever sneak on a naval ship in the 60s. She's in the Enquirer, and they didn't find her for 2 months.
Where was she?
She's from Bremerton, Washington. She was hiding with them white boys. My mother's all white, but then the Panthers came out. It's been niggas ever since. But listen, I have. And you know what's crazy? The threesome was me, a really good friend of mine, and her fine-ass boyfriend. And I have been staying there for years. Not staying there, but visiting for years. They're all really good friends of mine. And I know, you know, she was like, look, my boyfriend really loved, you know, da-da-da. And I was like, you know what? Why not? And at that point, I was like, I don't like bitches. Like, after that threesome, I was like, I don't like nobody.
We got a caller from Inglewood.
Inglewood?
Inglewood in the building.
Ryan from Inglewood, please tell us about sex on the first date or your threesome.
Okay, first of all, I want to shout y'all out. Y'all are awesome. My favorite comedian is Tony Baker.
Oh. Wait, I know who this is.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do.
It's comedian Ryan Loomis in the
yes,
building.
Yes, it is.
Sneaking up.
Yo, okay, so we talking about threesomes.
Okay.
My threesome was kind of scary because the girls was big.
Big? Okay. What do you mean by big? How big? What size? Paint the picture for us.
Stand next to Tony and measure across.
That's hilarious.
Me and Tony put together?
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. Hey, that's a foursome.
Yeah.
That was a foursome. It was a foursome.
Yeah.
You know, and they kind of ruined it for me. So it was, you know.
But did you go through with the threesome?
Yeah.
So you completed. Yeah. You
look at your face right now. Go look in the mirror at yourself right
how
now, Ryan.
How was it? No, how was it?
Let me know.
Was
you
it awesome?
You know, because it was like I was in college and I was like excited. I was like, yo, I got me two girls, yo.
Hey,
you know, but then now that I look back at it, it's like, you know, kill myself.
Oh, and, no.
Why? Just because they was big? They had pretty
because
faces?
I didn't enjoy it.
Why? What? Whoa, what do you mean you didn't enjoy it?
I mean, were you a two-pump chump on one and then kind of hung in there with the second one, or was it both?
No, I wasn't. I ain't never in my life or admit to being a two-pump chump.
Yeah, just relax, man. Just relax, all right? I'm sorry.
Okay. All right, thank you for calling in, Ryan, with your two-pump comp. Let me tell you something. Please tune in every Tuesday.
I got you.
Well, Young Guns of Comedy, we appreciate your support.
Appreciate it, Ryan.
Ryan out in Inglewood.
Inglewood? Inglewood? Yep. Next on the line, we got Miss Tiffany from Los Angeles. Los Angeles, you on the line. Let me let you know, have you ever had sex on a first date? And if so, was it a threesome?
Absolutely not for the second one.
Okay, then.
On the first one, yeah, why not? You want to know everything else about somebody on the first date. Why wait to figure out if they're small or not?
But
no, my question is, how can you think that you can know enough about a person and how you would actually be able to have sex with them if you don't know them? This is your first date. You just met them. So, I mean, clearly, if you get to know them better, it'll be better. So why even risk it?
Get to know what better? Some people are passionate and some people are not.
That's right. God
so,
damn,
wait.
If you don't have a passionate first date and you're connecting with somebody, I'm not saying fuck everybody you have a first date with. I'm saying that there are some people you have a connection with, and that's just
that's
what it is.
Right. How old are you, Tiffany, if you don't mind me asking?
Yeah, my name is Tish.
I'm sorry, baby. How old are you, Tish?
Tish sound like she got some titties on her.
29.
See, that's grown woman shit.
Great.
You
grown
woman
shit. Like, what are you waiting?
Hey, you ain't got
like,
what
are you still
what
are you with this man, Tish?
Attracted to somebody?
Are you still with this man?
Yeah, I got one.
The one that you had sex with on the first day. Like,
yeah.
You said she has him?
Yeah. Look at your face,
Shay. How many first dates have you had sex on, Tish?
Three.
Hell,
but you're not with two of them, so you down 60%.
You ain't gonna do sex with on a picnic.
I'm sorry,
that's
Tish.
That's a great point.
Look, Tish, there was the two.
Oh, I haven't had sex with anybody on the first day.
But I'm
Tish,
doing so. Well, so you waiting and you're not with everybody that you're with. Like, I don't make no sense, man. So, like, if you waited 10 days, it was better than you waited my one day.
Tish, I got the dude I was engaged to when I was in high school, and we was engaged. I didn't have sex with him for a year and a half until the first time, and now we're not together. Let me tell you something.
What's the difference?
There's a big difference.
Tish, you
don't know him. His penis could, like, make you... I don't know.
Fuck that shit, Tish.
Why did your penis can make you ew? I don't know. I mean, I'm just saying, like, your penis seems like you waiting and...
Tish, go
long
on
the penis? It's gonna end.
Thank you again, Tish, for calling in. We appreciate
you.
We love
Tish.
You. Make sure you tune in every Tuesday.
Bye.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna take you to Chick-fil-A, and we're gonna do something
and
on the
smash.
First date.
We got another caller.
We got another. Monty, come on now, Las Vegas. Let me hear your story.
702 in the building.
Yeah, what's up, y'all? What's up? This is my first time calling in, checking out the show. Y'all got me over here cracking up a little bit.
Thank you. It's our first show. This is Young Guns of Comedy, round one.
Bow, bow.
Right. Well, yeah, I had a couple of threesomes, and I had a threesome on the first date with one of the girls. It was our first date.
Wow. You're a pimp.
I like that shit. I like the Dolomite them hoes. You know what I'm saying?
Ladies, listen to how he's speaking. He likes to Dolomite the hoes.
That's right, Dolomite the hoes.
I just got back from Vegas. He sound like a nigga. I met him
Paul. You
gotta come back. You know I ain't gonna tell nobody.
Daddy, I'm gonna come back. Please.
Was it in public? If it's in public, that was a trifecta, sir.
Right.
Nah, I wasn't in public.
Yeah, but that's like Vegas, you know Vegas what I'm saying. That's fun. I mean, you gotta be ready for it. You can't be no buster when it comes to two women, especially if you all you care about is satisfying the women. So you gotta handle your business. So
this dude,
you know, so how do you know you satisfied them?
You,
how do you
not,
know
you're not gonna have fun if they just handling you and you feel like the victim? You know what I'm saying?
How do you know you handled them? Maybe you just feel like you handled them.
Dolomite is my name, and fucking up motherfuckers is
this dude is wearing Booker Green Davis right now. He is a pimp.
Do you smash Raw on the first date? Let's take it another level.
Let's talk about that.
I hope not.
Did I smash Raw on the first date?
Don't lie.
A couple of times I did.
Okay.
You know, I've been lucky. You know, like, I don't know. A lot of guys will lie to you and say they ain't never smashed Raw.
They will.
Smash
don't do
Raw
that.
First date.
Raw is Raw.
Sometimes, you know,
raw
you get that sick feeling, you get something in your gut that tells you not to, so...
I mean,
that's not true.
Suckers.
That's not true. Yeah, right. I'm a stop y'all on that. There's no feeling in your gut that lets you know the person you're about to sleep with does not have an STD.
Yes.
Mine smashed around 30 years. It gave me a feeling
angels
and I'm
on
safe.
Your side. The angels will tell you if they're good enough.
Okay, I got
you.
All right.
In
thank you. Monty, I want you to keep calling in, and I might want to see you next time we go to Vegas. Don't forget, our sponsor is KellyAnneProducts.com. Oh, it's always what's up, which is you, boop, pout. You might be able to put it in the bag. Don't forget. On the first day, Ustream. dot twitch.tv/on/air. Don't forget to call in because we had a mistake with the number, which is 323-965-1600. Young Guns of Comedy, first show, pal, we in this. Are we going to this next caller? Yes, Antoine from Florida. Let us know your business, boo.
No, that's old.
Yeah, also...
Oh, it's a new one.
Yeah, there's more than one nigga named Anton.
In Florida, though?
Did you see Antoine same Fisher? He ain't called in yet.
Antoine Dotson.
I thought it was. Okay, okay.
What's up, Antoine?
Hello? Can y'all hear me?
Yes, hi, Antoine.
I just never got to say congratulations, y'all, and hey.
Thank you.
I was that proud of y'all. I'm looking at y'all on my little TV, on my little screen. And Sylvia, I'm proud of y'all. Hey. What's up?
Hey, appreciate it, baby.
Looking all good and Tony looking all buff, and my ex roommate over there with the scarf on. And I don't know the girl with the weed.
With the fire.
Yeah. Don't forget the website. Tell your friends though, younggunsofcomedy.com. While you congratulations. Congratulations. Yeah, that's I've been drinking. That's yes, that. That's that sparkle shit.
Y'all live right on the beach.
Yep, I do.
Hey, I don't know what you said. I live on the beach.
We appreciate it, sir.
We do. Again, we're going to go to a quick break. Don't forget about our sponsor.
What?
Let me get professional on my white woman voice. All right, everybody. This has been Young Guns of Comedy. We're going to go on a quick break. But please, don't forget our sponsor, KellyOnProducts.com. You can get what you can get on the first date. If you put my shit on your hair, you might just hit.
On the first date.
On the first date.
Call in, y'all. Call in.
Hey.
Beautiful hair is what's up. Sexy hair is always in style. So beautiful, so soft, oh so Kellyanne. Try my leave-in conditioner for all hair types, especially extensions. Or my tomboy gel used by the one and only Sugar Shay Mosley. To learn more about Kellyanne products, go to www.kellyanneproducts.com. That's www.kellyanneproducts.com. Or join my Facebook page at Kelly Ann Hair. And remember, be beautiful today with Kelly Ann Products.
Bitches ain't shit but hoes and chicks. Bitches ain't shit but hoes and chicks.
ride too short and deep for this babe. Yes. So hold me, please don't marry that bitch.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Young Guns of Comedy. I am Shay Dixon. This lady over here doing these, they're not gang signs that she's throwing up.
No, those are first date signs. Like, who's there?
Oh. Right.
First date signs? I'm Tony Baker. Tony Baker Comedy on Twitter. Follow me.
And it's your boy BT Kingsley at BT Kingsley. Check me out on Twitter.
And you guys, make sure you tune in every Tuesday, 7 p.m. Pacific time, 10 p.m. Eastern, and 9 p.m. Central, where you're sure to get your laugh on.
And make sure you check out, so this week's, make sure you check this out online. The Have You Seen This is my boy Paige Kennedy's video, That's So Drake, Chris Boss edition. It is hilarious. So go on YouTube, look up Paige Kennedy. I promise you, and just watch all his videos. You will get a good, good laugh from it.
Oh, Paige is a fool. He's also from Weeds, right? And if you remember Leprechaun in the Hood, he was in that too.
He was in that too.
Paige
is
pretty funny.
Yeah, he was in what's that Western on FX? Justified. Yeah.
So what y'all got coming up this week?
Who, me?
Yeah, what you got coming up?
I host Crack 'Em Up Thursday, every Thursday at the Comedy Store on Sunset in Hollywood. And if y'all hit me up, the first 10 people to hit me up on Twitter at TonyBakerComedy.com, at TonyBakerComedy, first 10 people to hit me up, y'all get in free for Thursday night's show. It starts at 9:30, hosted by myself and DC Irvin. So first 10 people to hit me up, you get some free come-ins to the Crack 'Em Up Thursday show at the Comedy Store on the Sunset Strip this Thursday.
Pat, is there anybody there having sex on the first night?
You never know, man.
You never know at the Comedy Store.
I'm not.
Right now, we're in the middle of filming my project. It's called The Diary of a Cheating Woman. So I don't really have time to be on stage. I'm in the middle of writing. It'll be on Walmart and Redbox and in the next few months. So we're wrapping that up. And please check out Switching the Script. Other than that, I've just been writing and, you know, dealing with some personal stuff. So that's what's going on. And you can check me out at Kenesha's Comedy on Twitter to get my schedule if you want to catch me on stage. Bye.
Well, this week I'll be laying on the beach. I don't have any comedy shows like you guys. So you guys make sure you follow me on Twitter. And that's at Shay Dixon. My name is spelled like Shaw. Like, you know, I'm from the South. My parents did not know how to spell very well.
That's cool.
So
that's
it's S-H-A-D-I-X-O-N. And
so check out my website.
Hold on. I'm sorry. Now, we done all this talk about sex on the first date, threesomes, whatever. We even talked about unprotected sex. Bro. So one thing that I will be doing while I'm on the beach is reading a very good book. So the book I'm reading right now is called The Naked Truth. It's by a young lady named Marvelyn Brown. So if you go to www.marvelynbrown.com, you can get the book. It's her autobiography. And when you get the book and you read it, I want you guys to call in, because after that book, you will not want to have sex on the first date.
But is she giving head, though? That's what we want to know.
Well, you know, head got her into a situation that she cannot get out of. Uh-oh. She's married to that for life.
She ain't
like an H.
This week.
Shut up.
From Thursday to Sunday, I will be at the Toledo Funny Bone with the legendary Don DC Curry. So make sure you guys come out in Ohio. It's like two shows Friday, two shows Saturday, show Thursday, show Sunday. It's going to be crazy. Come see the legend all the way from Friday. Day Day Daddy. Y'all know who it is. Don DC Curry.
Day Day Daddy.
Day Day Daddy.
And again, thanks to Roscoe's Media Center for putting us down. Make sure you tune
Roscoe's
in again. Roscoe's. Let me get a number 9 po' boy. Now changed to the Obama.
Yeah.
No, you know, discretion about that.
Yeah. Also, we want to thank Billy from Texas, Candace from Texas, Tish from LA, even though you got a little feisty with me, Tish.
Hey!
Monty from Las Vegas and Antoine from Florida. Thank
Ryan?
You guys so much for calling. And Ryan from Inglewood. I knew
and
I was missing.
Shout out to our DJ who keeps it down. Come on, baby, baby.
This show was crazy.
DJ always. But this is how we going to end our show. Every time you tune in to Young Guns of Comedy,
this show
it's like
was
a freestyle.
Crazy.
What's going on? We going to start off with BT Kingsley.
This show was crazy. Girls having babies, cause they going raw. First date is crazy. One girl in Texas had a dude try to put it in the butt, he a fucking fool. He didn't even want to stuff, it's probably blue-eyed. What you know about that? What you know about? Make sure you tune in every week. Young Comedy Buns, I switch it up for fun. You know just how I run. Watch me pass them shits off. Do it, do it.
all right.
Do it, do it.
The awkward handoff. I must continue this freestyle. I got nothing. It's been a while. But hey, I keep going wild style. Yeah, old school, new school, middle school. I don't care. It's all good. I'm junior high. I don't know. But I'm about to pass the mic real quick before I go.
Yeah, cause it's a first date, man. I'm a hit and I'ma call you a wingman. Nah, bitch, I don't even need a wingman. If you buy me a plate of wings, I'm a hit man. Why? Cause I don't really give a fuck. It's the first date, yeah, bitch. And I'm gon' fuck. I wanna know what you got before I get deep into a shade. Don't give head, but bitch, I'm a pro. Do it. Nike. Be like Jordan. Not the bitch that be covering up in Jordan. I'm talking about the Muslims that don't give it up. Fuck it. If he want it, I'ma let him put it in my butt.
So I don't know how to freestyle very well.
Do what you do.
Thank you guys for tuning in. You have all become our friends. I will say this. Thank you so much to our sponsor, Kelly N. Kelly N Hair Products, where, as Kanisha has said all night, it will get you sex on the first date. So guys, go to www.kellyannproducts.com and get your hair gel and also your moisturizer, detangler, conditioning spray, and you'll be getting sex.
It smells really good, guys.
It does.
For real, it does smell good.
So it's Young Guns of Comedy every Tuesday.
Check us out on Facebook. Check out the website, Young Guns of Comedy. Make sure you follow us on Twitter, Young Guns of Comedy. You know what it is. Make sure you tune in next week. It's going to be crazy again. Roscoe's Media, we sure appreciate you.
And Kelly Ann Spa. Go ahead. Come on, Kelly. Come on in.
You've been an awesome guest. Come on.
Thank you for joining us.
Can you rap?
Join our Facebook.
I can't rap, so you can't.
Kelly's all that because she is cute. Get some hair care products and do the do.
Oh, yeah. Everybody rap it. Check it next week because I want to clean
get your
it
hair
up a
right.
little better.
Kellyanne Products, do it all night. It's the first date. I'ma do it like Mike. Put it in my hair. My shit is slick. I might bite.
Thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you join
thanks
us calling, next week.
Colin. Thanks for calling.
Bitch, I'm a Pico, Carlito, Scarface, Cappuccino, Bambino, MC, Arpedo. I goes deep in the pussy.